Well, good morning, everyone. This is a Travalgar Valentine. How's it going today? Hope everything's doing all right, and yeah, how's life and stuff, you know? So how's you keeping drawing up and stuff, you know? How's things going? Okay, today I'll be doing another vehicle drawing. Surprise, surprise. Today's gonna be one called the Frog. Sort of like an awesome 4x4 off-roader. I'm just sketching in some little shapes right now. So this is the front wheel, and it's doing sort of like a bunny hop, or like a front end wheelie or something like that. I'm not quite sure. But yeah, I'm just doing the back wheels now, just like so. Just using a B pencil for this. So it's nothing fancy. Just like I said, just getting these lines in, just to give me an idea of where I want things to go. Just doing some lines across, just trying to get these wheels right. I think that would work, because there's a crossbar going across here. Yeah, that'll work. I'll make it work. Okay, so that's that wide. For the same would be just here. Okay, now I've got the wheels in place, I can get me more of the body and stuff. So they've got these push bars at the front, which would be just to protect it from branches or fences, whatever it wants to smash through. Across here. You have to excuse me, I've never drawn these vehicles before, I never really do, so when you actually see me describing them and talking about them, I'm also kind of telling myself as well. I mean, I could draw these beforehand and give it practice, but I need to learn on the spot, you know, and then tell you how I do learn it. Yeah, it's just different suspension struts here. I'm just trying to work around them. Just getting shapes in, so you'll see more of what the shapes are in just a second. So this is like a cylinder going up here. Maybe another one just here. So this back panel. Underneath panel, so it comes across. And the main body, which comes underneath there. There, it's got two spotlights either side. This is actually by one of the Tamiya collections. It's actually surprising actually how much resource information I get from Tamiya vehicles and stuff. A lot of the vehicles that I like to draw with like labels on the side, so because I can't really copy them down with the name because of my phone that I download them with. So it's like model boxes basically. So this is like an RC car version, I think. No, they still look pretty awesome. Okay, so that's enough for my ramblings and rough lines. Let's get some ink work. Okay, where to start? Let's maybe start with this wheel first. And just to tell you what your pen I'm using here, it's just 0.4 nib. Although it's got a, actually I might use a better one, 0.3 unit pen. There we go, that's a bit better. Those Tidians are just cheap ones. Okay. Underneath here. Bring this around. And if you're new to this channel and you're just watching this, what I like to do is I like to just do the outline first. Sometimes I just do all the different shapes. And then I like to just go into a bit of shading. Sometimes I'll explain a little bit what type of shading I'm doing. The methods I'm using. The majority of it's all the same. Not necessarily the only way that I work, but it's just the way I work best with vehicles and cars and stuff. So you gotta find what works best for you. Then I'll go into a bit of time lapse. We'll see how it goes. That's what's planned anyway. Right. One wheel done. One more to go. Bring this one down. I try and mimic the same motions. So if that wheel is just like me turning my hand just like that. I'm gonna get to the top. Okay. It's kind of squashy on the bottom so it curls around. So I'm not worried about these little extra lines there because I'll be covered in shading anyway. Just to make sure I've got this outline just the way I want it. And just doing a center wheel hub on the rim. Okay, that looks really strange just because of the angle it's at, but it'll get there, it'll look cool, it'll look awesome, don't worry. Right, let's do this crossbar here. So this just comes down. It's got a slight curve here. So I'm just going to flick that up. Just bring this up. Just remember when you're doing double lines like this, try and keep it the equal distance throughout. There we go. Okay. Bring this crossbar. Cross. So what do you like to do when you draw? Do you like to just have nothing in your hand and have complete silence? Or do you like to actually be like me, who's multitasking and do lots of things while drawing at the same time? I'm actually just listening to music today, but sometimes I'll have a drink going, maybe like coffee and stuff like that, because it is currently 3:31 in the morning here in England. I'm listening to some awesome music, one of my favorite bands, Buckethead. The reason is I'm up so early is because I start work in a few hours. And if you won't have time to do art in your life, you've got to make the sacrifice and get your ass out of bed. Okay, so I'm just doing the suspension line here. And then I noticed this line follows down to just underneath it. Just like so. Okay. Okay, there's another block that goes here. This comes up. I've just noticed my proportions are a little bit off. This is not 100% perfect, but I'll make it work. This should be an awesome drawing, don't worry. Just because this is supposed to be a little bit more further in than this, but it's fine, it's fine, it's cool. It's good, it's good. Okay, it's looking good. Just a little tricky with all these different bars underneath. See, there's a skinny little cylinder in here, which has a crossbar going across. Then there is a plate that comes down here. Down. This has got five holes in it. Oh, my hand is starting to cramp up. Why is my hand starting to cramp up? So annoying. You ever get that when you're trying to draw an awesome picture, then your hand decides to go, no, screw it, I'm cramping up for you. Ooh. Okay, work through it. Draw this up. Did I say something about just drawing the basic shapes first? Wonder when that ended. A little confusing because it looks like the car is different on one side than the other. Maybe I should have reviewed this and maybe got some other pictures of it. It's working. Okay, second. The main struts, just on the wheel. This is the most difficult part of the drawing, just drawing these little bits and bobs. Just beforehand, just underneath the vehicle. They got a nice smooth sleek body on top to look forward to afterwards. Yeah, that's looking good. So you can see we've got the front axle here, and they've got the suspension struts which are being here. This is going to be the lower suspension just here. Which we're doing now. And I do apologise in advance if I do hop, skip and jump across different parts of the drawing. I might not finish one area of the drawing before I finish the other one. I'm sort of like the Dory version of when it comes to drawing. I'm just doodling one section and it's like, ooh, here comes a wheel. Ooh, what about this? It's just the way I draw. I just get a little bit distracted. Oh, it could be my dyslexia, I don't know, whatever, but yeah. Let's just keep this on the same level. Oh, seriously? I've got pins and needles in both my hands now? Ooh. Okay, okie dokie, okie dokie. Which time are we on now? Well, nearly 20 minutes. 17 minutes, sorry. 20 minutes, I'd say. Yeah, it's alright. So, let's do this section. How's that wheel looking? Into the night, I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through. Okay, just doing the inner mechanism, so tire. This. Okay, so main complicated bit all sorted. Let's do some of the body sections. here. Spotlight here.
Eyes in the sky, gazing far into the night. I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through. If you believe it's true, baby, won't you let the light shine through?
Do pan on the top. There's like a small little cage where the driver will sit. Down. Okay, this looks pretty awesome. Right, let's see if there's anything else. I want to do some shading. Okay. Do a bit of shading, shall we? Few copic markers, like 4 or 5 different shades of black and grey. That's going to be the majority of what I'll be using, just for all the different shading. Center. Okay, little bit of black in first. Slightly darker dark grey. Guys, I'm just slowly getting through there. Sorry, I went off a little bit tangent, didn't really explain much, but as you can see, I'm just adding different shadows just to the shapes. I'm using my five different copic markers just to give me different tones of darkest to slightly lightest grey in all the different areas. The grey for all this is going to be like grey at the bottom. The dark areas is just the kind of the ones in between all these little dark nooks and crannies that you won't see, that won't have any light on them. A little bit of light underneath just from the dirt relaxed, and I'll bring in some brown copic markers in a bit once I've finished the whole body. We'll see how it goes, but I'm gonna leave it for now. Today I'll come back tomorrow and you'll see the transition. One sec. Okay, guys, I think I'll leave it there. So, as you can tell, I've done quite a bit more work. I've continued the shading with the 5 different copic markers with the different grey tones just on the wheels and a little bit underneath and a little bit inside the cab. Then I've got a few grey copic markers, brown copic markers as well, where I just left a little bit of wheel marks just around there, making it darker underneath. Gone with a bit of brown biro as well, just for a bit of transition. I've also added the greens as well just underneath, give a nice cool speedy effect. As you can see, I've done it kind of ricocheting off the tyres around here. And then I also went into a few blues here just for the undercoat of the body. Got the two spotlights there, their happy smiley face. I've continued to put grey on this side, leave this side white. And added a few highlights with the gel pen. Altogether, this took me about an hour, but yeah, I think it looks pretty awesome. So, let's put my John Hancock here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Okay, guys, I think I'll leave it there. So, as you can tell, I've done quite a bit more work. I've continued the shading with the 5 different copic markers, with the different grey tones just on the wheels, and a little bit underneath and a little bit inside the cab. Then I've got a few grey copic markers, brown copic markers as well, where I just left a little bit of wheel marks just around there, making it darker underneath. Gone with a bit of brown biro as well, just for a bit of transition. I've also added the greens as well to underneath, give a nice cool speedy effect. As you can see, I've done it kind of ricocheting off the tyres around here. And then I also went into a few blues here, just for the undercoat of the body. Got the two spotlights there, their happy smiley face. I've continued to put grey on this side, leave this side white. And added a few highlights with the gel pen. Altogether, this took me about an hour, but yeah, I think it looks pretty awesome. So, let's put my John Hancock here. Thanks so much for watching, guys.